It's like a journey through someone's mind and their perspective.
It documents the surroundings, it documents the way we think, it documents the way we see.
It is a portal into the potential of every human being.
Why are we here? Do we matter? And why do we matter?
People can see themselves in the art and it affirms their existence. People have set the narrative for us in the border about what we're supposed to be, and artists are the first ones to be able to dispel that. Because you can talk and talk all you want, but until they see your representation of your community and your art and your photography and so forth, they don't really get an idea of what the streets of Laredo are.
Art is a journey that starts with a thought, an empty space, where we pick up the scraps, often unnoticed, the tossed aside and left behind. The possibility is everywhere and everything in between. Miles and moments that brought us before. What could be?
I've been to visit different events in Brownsville and in McAllen and in San Antonio, and everybody wants to say they're bicultural and they have this, oh, come visit, we have such great culture. And I'm always let down because what we have in Laredo is so much more.
The Spanglish.
Our music.
The food.
The way we talk.
The culture.
The way we dress.
La gente.
It's not here or there. You know, everybody's always talking about ni de aquí ni de allá.
We can be having a piñata, but at the same time playing hip hop.
It's constantly challenging itself and reinventing itself. The Laredo from 5 years ago isn't Laredo today. 5 years before that, it's a different city. 5 years before that. There's just so much flux in the city itself, you know, because of its relationship to the border.
We can get the best of both worlds. We can get the best of the US and Mexico, but at the same time, we can take both, we can destroy both, and then we make our own.
Our vibrant cultural landscape has provided inspiration to generations of local artists. Meet Mauro Martinez.
So in Laredo, Texas, my mission was just basically to just be the artist that I wanted to be, you know, to whatever degree I could. And I found it to be a very unique and supportive and nurturing and stable environment to be very experimental in.
One of our local artists who's garnered international acclaim. Mauro's art has been featured in group and solo exhibitions across the United States and London.
So the work that I have, I think there's just a lot of curiosity to it. Particularly, I'm asking questions, mostly about the world that we live in and how it's changing and where it's going and where it's come from.
A lot of the artists who are from Laredo, not being able to have access, not only to materials, but to other artists, we end up finding opportunities elsewhere and we end up leaving.
Art does not magically appear on walls. It has to be paid for. Artists are not robots. They need to make a living.
Laredo is growing. I think it needs more.
How often have we heard from our children when we ask them, are you coming back to Laredo? How often have we heard, Mom, Dad, I'm not going back to Laredo. I love the community I'm in. They have symphonies, they have concerts, they have museums, they have a lot of cultural events which are important to me. I would love to come back to Laredo and be with my family, but that aspect of life brings me joy.
Space
is very hard to come by.
So I currently work in an 8x10 storage space in my garage.
I work entirely from my room.
People need a place to make and show what they've done.
There's a lot of talent, but it's like everything. You need to have an opportunity to showcase your talent and then for somebody to appreciate it.
Let's talk about the economic impact of the arts and what that means to Laredo. Last year in Laredo, we made about $598,000 worth of sales directly related to the arts, and that was $60,000 to our local taxes. That's a lot of money, but we can do better. You know, we used to have a lot of tourism in Laredo, back when Mexico was open to us and we could freely go, and it was such a big deal. People would come down and stay locally and spend locally and go across the river and enjoy everything that we had. We haven't been able to do that in 18 years. So what can we do? We can have more arts in Laredo.
In the last several years, we've witnessed the creation of several arts advocacy organizations, including Daphne Art Foundation.
So the Daphne Art Foundation is a nonprofit organization that was created to support the visual, media, and performing arts in Laredo. One of the things that I'm very proud that the Daphne Art Foundation does is promote artists by giving them an in-residency program.
Cultivarte was one of those residencies that me living in Laredo allowed me to actually do the residency.
I had always wanted to do a residency, but it seemed kind of out of reach because you have to like leave your home, you have to go away for a long period of time. You know, you kind of can't have a job, you have to depend on that residency. So when Cultivarte came out, it was a great opportunity. It gave me a stipend to work with, which was really great because art material is very expensive. It gave me a mentor that I could work with and meet in with when I was feeling insecure about all of my like decisions, where I was going to go with my project. And it gave me the motivation to move forward.
Me having that type of connection with Laredo and kind of going back and help the Cultivarte, I feel like I'm providing something different, a different perspective.
Doing the residency at Cultivarte really made a huge impact to where I am now. And if I hadn't done the residency, I don't know where my work would be. They really acknowledged the input of the artists. And no one else is doing this here in Laredo. There's not a lot of resources like this.
Having somebody else with a different fresh or different perspective can really broaden your ideas, your outcomes.
It makes me feel like there's someone out there that really cares about me as an artist and the work that I'm making.
And although we are making progress as a community, it is nowhere near enough.
We need our local government to get behind it and say, this is important. This has something to do with the quality of our life.
As soon as budgets get tight, what's the first thing that happens? Oh, let's eliminate the arts. Art will bring wealth to our community.
The hope is there, the future is there.
Everyone's always trying to put down Laredo, but I think it's like what you make of it.
The arts can revitalize the community.
If you haven't gone to a slam or to, you know, a display or to the theater here, go. A lot of people say, hey, you know, that's better than a lot of, you know, New York productions that I've seen. The poetry is a lot more real to me. In terms of music, Laredo musicians have always been able to go and play anywhere in the world.
Every interface, every show on Netflix that you enjoy was made by somebody who came from somewhere. At one point, nobody knew who their name was, and now, you know, more people do, and it's really cool. It's a really cool thing and special when you get to support somebody before anybody else knows who they are.
Our youth that are coming back and they're trying to do something, they're trying to make an impact. And we don't want them to get frustrated, give up, get depressed, leave.
Those of us who can, we have to give and give generously.
We need to celebrate their accomplishments and their triumphs and their attempts and by showing up and applauding and encouraging them.
If we want our children to return to our community and watch them grow, work, have their children, enjoy the grandchildren, we have to provide a much better environment.
How we time travel with a brushstroke. How we world build with a pen. How we cradle potential. The road from inspiration to creation might as well be a flight to the moon. But still, we take it. So here it is. I bring you the moon to hold. No strings attached. Just the wonder that you never knew what could always be yours. From nothing, we create an unexpected spark in the heart. For you to feel limitless, for you to feel the world the way you want to see it.